concrete is everywhere. The use of this ubiquitous man-made material continues to rise. We make 30 billion metric tons of it every year, more than any other material on the planet. But concrete has a problem. For every kilogram we produce, we release a kilogram of CO2. Cement production generates a whopping 8% of all human CO2 emissions. But what if we turn this problem on its head? What if cement captured CO2 rather than creating it?
When I think about products that could actually utilize CO2 or store CO2, concrete kind of bubbled up to the top for me because the CO2 can be stored in concrete as a solid species. There's no risk of re-emission.
CarbonBuilt from UCLA's Institute for Carbon Management was one of two grand prize winners in the Energy COSIA Carbon XPRIZE. This competition challenged teams to convert CO2 emissions into usable products. CarbonBuilt's winning technology reduces the carbon footprint of concrete by more than 50% while reducing costs and increasing profitability.
Our team was comprised of students and professors, and you know, this wasn't their kind of full-time job or even priority. The design of the competition really forced these students to deliver milestones in a timely manner that would have probably not happened if that didn't exist.
The competition helped the team implement two key manufacturing differences. First, the use of biomass waste. That's renewable organic materials generated by plants, animals, and microorganisms.
Cement is like the glue or binder that holds the sand and the gravel and all the other pieces that make up concrete together. But the production of cement releases a lot of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. And our technology replaces most of the cement with other lower carbon waste materials that can also interact with carbon dioxide and store that in the concrete product. We found a solution in biomass, and we bought, you know, a biomass furnace and dryer, brought that to site, and used the flue gas from the burning of biomass to be our CO2 source for our curing chambers.
The second difference in CarbonBuilt's process is concrete curing. Instead of using steam generated by natural gas for curing, they use carbon dioxide at ambient pressure, which uses far less water. CarbonBuilt cement mix reacts with CO2 to form calcium carbonate, otherwise known as limestone. The end result is a strong, durable cement that permanently stores CO2. Since the competition, CarbonBuilt has begun commercial production of low-carbon concrete blocks in Alabama.
We were able to raise a Series A round very quickly, and I think just having that validation from XPRIZE was able to convince, you know, investors that our technology was worth betting on and kind of opened a lot of doors for us to get the funding we needed to build out our team and really commit to building a business. In some way, it still surprises me that that building is made up of our block. And I think it's just really cool to see it in action and know that they're building with, you know, a 70% lower footprint product.
But the team isn't stopping there. They're committing to increase their impact and help other industries address the climate crisis.
Ultimately, we'd love for all of the concrete block producers in the U.S. to implement or use CarbonBuilt technology, and that's about 700 plants. And then further down the line to expand to other precast products and wet cast concrete, both here in the U.S. and globally, and really just make ultra low carbon concrete kind of the standard and the norm, and not have to work so hard to convince people that this is a good idea for the environment. I think in order to start saving not only the environment, but people, we have to really put a lot of effort into addressing this. And there's no one solution. I think it has to come from people working in concrete, people working in chemicals, fuels, direct air capture, geological sequestration. I think all of these are solutions that need further exploration and working together to start removing the critical amounts of CO2 in the atmosphere that we need to create a more kind of stable environment for the future to come.
CarbonBuilt success speaks to the power of incentivized competitions like XPRIZE to accelerate solutions to large-scale problems.
I think every idea deserves exploration. Even if it hasn't been thought through from beginning to end, I think you are given the grace period to develop and redevelop that idea. So I think if you're excited about something, go for it.
To learn more and join a team, head to xprize.org.